The high maternal mortality rates, limited ownership of land and property, sexual abuse, female genital mutilation, among others, are some of the challenges affecting women in East Africa. Since 2008, the East African Sub-Regional Support Initiative for the Advancement of Women, EASSI, in partnership with the top five East African community states, has been campaigning for the East African Equality Protocol. This later changed into a bill, which was tabled at the East African Legislative Assembly, YALA, as a private member's bill. These now want the East African Legislative Assembly to pass the bill into law in order to advance gender equality in the member states. Christine Nankubuge is the program officer, EASSI.
For the benefit of women and men, by consolidating into one legally binding document the various human rights instruments to which EASSI partner states are party and have actually signed.
But even as the bill progresses towards being passed as law, there is no legal framework that provides authoritative information that can be referred to in order to hold East African community states accountable on their gender commitments, hence the need for the East African Gender Barometer as a key advocacy tool.
The Gender Barometer, we are trying to look for information. For example, how many women are able to access maternal health care? How many women and girls are able to access education vis-a-vis the boys? So in some places you find that actually there are more girls attending school than the boys.
Honorable Sheila Kawamoro of Uganda Women's Movement says the law will solve problems associated with the East African community member states trying non-citizens who commit crimes there.
But we would want to have a standard law so that when I'm in South Sudan as an East African citizen, I'm not tried under a culture court, but we are able to have the same standards. And then our countries are able to put in place gender responsive legislations, laws that we are able to say this law does not conform to the East African Gender Bill.
The former Speaker of the East African Legislative Assembly, Margaret Nantongo Ziwa, says the East African Gender Equality and Development Bill was received by the Assembly and now before public hearings.
In the next calendar year of the East African Legislative Assembly, we are going to come to the respective partner states and interface with you on this bill.
The East African Sub-Regional Support Initiative for the Advancement of Women, EASSI, covers Burundi, Eritrea, Ethiopia, Kenya, Rwanda, Somalia, Tanzania, and Uganda. Benard Yiga and Sudat Kaye, UBC, in Kampala.